home decoration decisions alone because I'm the only one who's interested.
You seem to be carrying some hostility. Is there something you want to share?
Ever had a girlfriend? No.
Have you got another boyfriend at uni or something?
Hi.
The big deal is soccer. 100% dedication. Full time. Full stop.
Ah! Want to go to the ball with the best looking guy in town or what?
Wow, you both look so beautiful.
In fact, I own a magazine called Slick. And I'd love you to write us a regular column, as long as it's got your attitude and your style. Give me a call if you're interested.
Maybe I'll do that.
Thank you, Doctor. I feel so much better.
Will Mrs. Erdogan be needing another appointment?
Oh, yes, please. The doctor has such a warm, healing touch.
11 a.m. Tuesday?
Till then, Doctor. Au revoir.
A warm, healing touch.
Yeah. Is doctor business?
Oh, yeah, just a little article on
Men who sleep around are still seen as heroes, while women who do the same are skanky hoes. Why do men get all the fun and women all the guilt?
So? Sex is natural. You're a doctor. You understand about natural urges and hormones and all that.
Yeah, well, they stopped teaching about natural urges at medical college some time ago. But I obviously have my own personal experiences. Yes, in the words of Janis Joplin, tomorrow never happens, so get it while you can.
It's not necessarily about me. I'm just asking the question. Hey, I haven't had sex. But I could if I wanted to.
Yes, of course you could.
You don't believe me?
Oh, sure I do.
Okay, Dr. Kinsey, how's your sex life?
Quite adequate, thank you. Obviously, more so than yours.
Just because I haven't had any calls in the last 5 minutes doesn't mean I'm not one in-demand babe. In fact, I'd prefer no sex to bad sex. Hello, Sydney Road Clinic. Oh, hi, John. Yeah, long time. Uh-huh. Maybe, yeah. Stuff's still there. Come and get it. Beef and I'll run out. Okay, bye.
Come and get it? Sounds like you'll be venting your natural urges tonight.
Hey, get it while you can.
Mickey?
I know. You're wondering who is John.
No. I was wondering if Mr. Mateo's test results were back.
Thank you.
The case was Rodin's masterpiece. Look at that extraordinary sensuality. See if you can emulate something of this in your work. See how the movement of the muscle resonates with the passion of this kiss. See how the pleasure of this kiss seems to pulse through the bodies of the lovers. I personally find this extraordinary, this piece.
It's big, it's huge, it's massive. Mate, it's fantastic. I'm seeing food and produce from everywhere.
Yeah, well, the owner's having trouble leasing the space.
It's perfect. I'm seeing the United Nations of Food all under one roof or subleasing.
All right, so could you come up with some sort of plan?
Is the Dalai Lama a Buddhist?
All right, you come up with a plan and I'll put it to Mr. Huggins.
You want a plan? Hua Tran is your man.
Yeah. Good. Use your head.
Yeah.
Mickey, can you round them up for me?
Sure. Okay, everyone, bring it in. Our fearless leader wants to talk.
Okay, I want to announce the team. Tatiana will be captain.
Oh, how does that happen, Mr. Barrow? Your daughter just happens to be captain.
The coach chooses the captain. It happens all over the world.
Yeah, what's the problem?
What if someone else wants to be captain?
The decision is final. What else do you want? Video referee? Huh? Easy is vice captain. Well, what are you looking at? Enough talking! More training! Come on! Do the headers!
Hey, Zorina, this decision, wouldn't it be better to sort of workshop it like a democracy kind of thing?
Democracy is a Greek myth. Hey, it's a Mickey Mouse story to keep the masses happy. You know, the coach must choose the captain. The coach must rule with an iron fist. That's the best policy.
Okay, I'm hearing you, but if you start getting the urge to conquer Poland, just take a deep breath.
What are you crazy?!
Sorry, Mum.
Madam, we apprehended your son driving a car underage without a licence.
You don't understand, they'd all been drinking so they couldn't drive.
Who was drinking? thinking?
Tyne, Dumbo and Slinky.
Who are these people, Dumbo, Stinky?
Slinky.
And these are people that are so important to you that you're willing to risk our good record with the police and the community.
I'm sorry, Mum.
When did you learn to drive?
A while ago.
I didn't know anything about this.
Yeah, well, there's a lot of things you don't know about me, all right?
Like, you're a criminal. My own son, and I don't know anything about him. Osama Habibi, from now on, you do not leave this house without my permission. Fintule!
Oh, why can't I see him?
I told you, I'm not bringing him inside the house.
It's my house, I invite him in.
When we were together, you didn't want to know the guy.
In those days, I thought you could do better, but then I stopped dreaming.
Look, Mum, I don't need you to get involved in my love life.
Love life? What love life? You don't have a love life. You can't even get a man.
You step outside this door and I will tell John exactly what you called his mother at Jimmy's funeral.
All right.
Hey, Mickey, look at... Wow! Your hair's grown. You're looking hot, girl.
Here's your stuff.
Oh, okay. Well, I should probably say hi to your fox.
Mum really doesn't want to see you.
Really? Oh. Hey!
Hey, Mickey, we should go out to dinner. You know, we can kick back, catch up, stuff.
Since when have you been into kicking back and stuff?
People change.
Into what?
So I've got to get on to stripping the walls in the spare bedroom because we're way behind schedule.
Schedule? What? I didn't even know we had a schedule.
Darling, I know it's a chore, but do you think of how good we're going to feel when it's done?
Oh, terrific.
Lord knows we could do with some cheering up around here.
Cheering up? No, sweetheart. I'm as happy can be. I mean, come on. I work all day and then we come home and I renovate all night. And did you know that celibacy is the new in thing amongst neoconservative Christians? I mean, the fact that I'm a lapsed Hindu has got nothing to do with it.
Well, the use of sarcasm to make a point unrelated to the discussion at hand is both futile and mean-spirited, Joe.
I got a bottle of red at home, I got the day off tomorrow, and I want to spend the next 24 hours horizontal with you.
You're unbelievable.
I know. Hey, I know you've been angry with me. And I am sorry.
Oh, wow. Thanks for the belated foreplay, yeah. But there's this show I really want to watch on TV, so see you.
Mickey, no.
Hey, hon! Sweetie! Okay, run away, just run off. Typical.
Hey, what's that? Wally Mart?
You have no idea. World Mart, okay? The total international market. It's gonna be huge, mean Ames. We're gonna be rolling in it.
You and Eamon rolling in what?
That Eamon has too many faces.
Can you just lay off Eamon? If he can get me to Mr. Hakim, I'm going to cut him in.
Good night.
You know what you need for that?
What?
My tech drawing program.
Thanks for the offer, OK? But this is what I do. I turn dreams into reality. OK?
OK.
Hey, did you hear the rumours going round? Tats Daddy's gonna rename the team. It's gonna be Team Tats.
Maybe we should name after you instead. Team Try Hard. You wanna be captain? Go for it.
Maybe I will.
You think I care? I don't even wanna be captain. Good morning.
Yeah.
Somebody get Dr. Grumpy a chill pill, please.
Well, good morning, Ms. Chirpy. How was John?
Well, he confessed his undying lust for me. Yawn. Still, a girl likes to be noticed.
So he's not one of your get-it-when-you-can guys?
Nah. John's just an ex who pops up like a karmic zit when I least expect it. So how was the mood over at Casa del Joe?
Oh, you know, mood was adequate.
So no action at your place either, huh? At least we didn't wake up with guilt and remorse for breakfast. The beauty of no sex is that you get to live in a state of constant sexual hypothesis.
There she is, my star columnist. Do I have something for you? Reaction to your article has been fantastic. My editor's been raving. I want your follow-up piece ASAP.
Really? How ASAP?
Oh, we'll talk about it over dinner.
Dinner?
I'll pick you up at your place. Now, don't worry, doctor.